गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। वी आर इन केनो उपनिषद चैप्टर टू वर्स नंबर थ्री वी आर गोइंग ऑन यस नंबर थ्री वी आर गोइंग ऑन एंड हियर वी आर लुकिंग एट यस्या मतं तस्य मतं मतं यस्य न वेदसः अविज्ञातं विजानतां विज्ञातं अविजानतां एंड ही हु नोज ही डजंट नो एंड ही हु डजंट नो ही नोज दीज टू कॉन्ट्रडिक्टरी स्टेटमेंट्स वर मेड बाय द स्टूडेंट एंड वी आर एट Page 72 or 73, somewhere there. So what is the student saying? That the person who has come to know the truth directly, immediately, without any doubt, without any and has come to know Brahman immediately, aparokshatvena. For such a student, for such a seeker, for such a person, the truth, the Brahman, is unknown. He who has come to know the reality directly, for him, the truth remains unknown. And those who say that they know it only because their attention is on the conditionings, limitations of thought, of the knower, of the experience, etc. Why is it said that if one has come to know directly, it remains unknown to him? Why is it said that way? Because there's no because, it is a statement of fact. First point, the seeker can never come to know Brahman. So the one who is seeking the truth, the one who is wanting to know the truth, the knower who wants to know the truth, when he comes, you will say face to face with the truth. But we are not saying that. We are saying that he comes to know the truth as the truth directly. And is that directly possible objectively? If I am seeing you, is this direct perception? Direct perception, when we are look in the area of reality, is not through the senses. It is not through the mind. Then our nature itself is that of reality. reality. So when we merge back into being who we already are, then all the hats that we are wearing of the seeker, of the intellectual, of the knower, of the experiencer, of the seeker, all these hats vanish. Why they vanish? Because the seeker vanishes. The one who was searching, he vanishes. The Triputi vanishes. And therefore, if you take this example, therefore, he cannot come to know Brahman because there is no individuality left thereafter. How will he come to know the truth as separate from himself? Just like a dreamer, when he wakes up, when he wakes up, can he come to know himself? That now I have come to wake up, I have woken up now. Now let me go and revisit the dream body, the dream wife, the dream children, and the dream world. Can you revisit it? Ask this question. If you cannot revisit it, same thing is here also. Once the seeker comes to directly experience the reality, atmatvena, then what is the status of the dream experience for you? Same will be the status of dream experience for this one who has had the direct thought-free abidance in his own essential nature. Now, don't go into this tangent of thought. But then what will happen to my wife? What will happen to my children? What will happen to my husband? What will happen to my investments? Are you worried about your investments, wife and children in the dream? If you're not worried every morning about what happened in the dream, then when you wake up from the waking dream, you will not be available to the waking world also, waking experience also. Then what will happen to them? That is not your concern. What will happen to all the people in the waking dream? In the dream? What happened to your wife? Do you ever shed a tear for her? Do you ever shed a tear for the for the children that you had in the dream? For the experiences that you had in the dream? There also you had memory. There also you had a future. But when you wake up, what happens to that past? What happens to that future? What happens to those attachments? What happens to those relationships? Let this go deep into your heart and psyche. Why nothing happens to them? Because they are not there in the first place. They are only a projection of your mind. Exactly the same way, this waking dream also is nothing but a mere projection of the mind. And the moment you wake up to your essential nature, the status of this dream is null and void. It's important. See? From the reality point of view, nothing but reality remains. So in this manner, it was told, we were at page 71, last word. Buddhyadi upadhescha vijnatatvad viditam brahmetyupadyate bhrantiriti ato asamyak darshanam purvapakshatvena upanyaste vijnatam avijanatam iti. So these people, who are these? दीज आर दीज पीपल हु नहि तेषां विज्ञातां विज्ञातम अस्माभिर् ब्रह्मेति मतिर्भवति इंद्रिय मनो बुद्धि उपाधित्व उपाधिषु आत्मदर्शिनां तु ब्रह्मोपाधि विवेकानुपलम्भात्. सो हु आर दीज पीपल? दीज आर दोज पीपल who are established in ignorance. See, there are two people who cannot come to know reality. Who are that? Those who are established in reality cannot come to know reality, that I have known reality. And those who are utter ignorant, buddhu, bewakuf, they also cannot come to know because they are not interested in knowing only. And who are in between are like us. Seekers. Why? And what is our status? Our status is that Indriya, Mana, Buddhi, we want to know the reality through these three instruments, which is not possible. See, get this clear. The realized person doesn't say that he is realized or doesn't say that I know I am realized. The ignorant person also is not realized. And those who say, I am very clear, now I have understood, everything is spick and span now. I know the pathway, I know the destination, I think I am already there. Okay. Who are these? They are assessing that which cannot be assessed by the equipments, and therefore it is told they have the abhiman, they have the arrogance that they know. Those who are absolutely wise and those who are absolute fools, they are always happy, and those who are in between, like you and me, we are always crying. And what is our cry? I want to realize. I think I know, but people don't understand that I know it. I have studied so many Upanishads. I studied this text and I studied that text. I know this Mahatma and I know that Mahatma. I have got the grace of so many Mahatmas. But people don't recognize that I am a realized one, you know. This is our lot. Why? We have only intellectually appreciated it. We haven't directly come to know it. We are still objectifying. Intellectual means we are still objectifying the reality, meaning we are still searching for reality as an experience to be had. It is not an experience to be had like I am having your experience, or I am having the experience of these verses given in Keno Upanishad. On the contrary, this is an experienceless experience. It is me. It is the self alone. It is the I alone. And this is where we go wrong. Anyway, these people, those who are hanging in between, these people are unable to apply this knowledge on themselves. They want others to come to know that they know it. Then they'll prove it. They'll try to say it. They'll give lectures for it. But that doesn't work. Then, बुद्ध्यादि उपाधेश्च विज्ञातत्वात् विदितं ब्रह्मेत्युपपद्यते भ्रांतिरिति अतः असम्यक् दर्शनं पूर्वपक्षत्वे नोपन्यस्ते न उपन्यस्ते न्यस्यते विज्ञातं अविजानतां इति. सो हियर ही सेज दैट द that therefore that one who has understood, the one who, just like our student said, that I have very well come to know the reality, I have understood the reality. So anyone who emphatically says that he has come to know the reality, he has not come to know the reality. This is here the conclusion being taken, and here he says, where are we? Athva hetuhu artha uttarardho avignatam ityadihi. And therefore, basically, such person, he who says that he has come to know, has not really come to know. Avignatam vijanatam iti avadhrutam. So therefore, that is the conclusion. Yadi, यदि ब्रह्मात्यंतम् एव अविज्ञातम् लौकिकानां ब्रह्मविदां च विशेषः प्राप्तः अविज्ञातम् विजानताम् इति च परस्पर विरुद्धम्. सो ही सेज इफ ब्रह्मन् कैनॉट बी नोन, इफ ब्रह्मन् कैनॉट बी नोन, देन अ फूल एंड अ वाइज बोथ आर सेम. If Brahman cannot be known, he is thinking from our point of view. What was told before? Vijanatam avignatam. So, if we do not, if the wise does not know the truth, or the truth is unknown to the wise, you know how it is? Truth is unknown to the wise. Is the heat and light known to the sun? Is heat and light known to the sun?
No.
No, Swamiji. Heat and light are the sun.
Yes. It's the character of the sun, Swamiji.
So sun cannot come to know the heat and light objectively, isn't it?
Yeah.
Exactly the same way. The one who knows the truth cannot come to know the truth. Or is the truth is unknown to him because it is his nature. He cannot see the truth as separate to him. Vijanatam. Avignatam. Kya tha word? Avignatam. He cannot come to know because it is inherent. It is his nature. How can you separate his nature from himself? And then say, oh yeah, that is what I came to know. Come on, get back to me now. Can he do that? No. So keep this example in your mind. Just as sun cannot come to know the heat and light as separate from itself, exactly the same way, the one who knows the truth remains unknown to him. Meaning he cannot talk about it in an objective manner. And what are we doing? Only talking about it in an objective manner. Take this Upanishad, take that Upanishad. So where are we lacking? Where are you and me lacking? If we have studied Vivek Chudamani, we have studied Ishavasya Upanishad, now we are doing Keno Upanishad, we are doing Amrita Anubhav. Where are we lacking then?
Still thinking it is somewhere out there.
That is not the answer.
We are intellectually trying to understand that, Swamiji.
That is also not the answer.
Right.
Both the answers seem to be the correct one.
We are passing our time, Swamiji.
That is true. That is true, passing our time. Mahatma is also passing his time. Realized Master is also passing his time.
Okay.
Swamiji, the seeker knows about it. He doesn't know the, he knows of it, but he doesn't know that he is it.
We are not. See, whatever answers you gave, both of you, it was objective in approach.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
The answer was objective in approach. So why don't we know it? Because we do not apply this knowledge while listening on ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Immediately the attention shifts. Immediately, whatever is being read, whatever is being heard, whatever is being talked, mouth is talking. Who is the first person hearing now? Are you the first person who's hearing, or I am hearing, but this mind is hearing, the first person to hear it. Now, while the mind is hearing it, is it still trying to formulate a concept, or is that whatever the verses or the words are being communicated, coming out, are they taking us to the principle? This point will be told in the next verse. Are they taking us to the substratum? Are we still looking for the answer, as you both said? Or are we applying it on ourselves, that this one, this unknowable, this reality, I essentially am? See? See, our Arjun Maharaj, he came with a problem, he got the solution, he fought the war of Mahabharata, Dharma Kshetra, Kurukshetra, and after the war again he became ignorant. He did not remain a wise man. He did not realize himself. So he had a breakdown. Krishna Bhagwan, through the Bhagavad Gita, brought him out of his breakdown, inspired him. He came to the conclusion, Karishye Vachanam Tava, I'll do whatever you say. He fought the war. And after the war, again, after some time, he went into depression. He went into sadness when Krishna left his body and left the abode. Earthly abode. He couldn't even pick up the Gandiva. He couldn't protect all the wives of Krishna. On the other hand, Lord Rama also lost the plot when he was 15, 16 years old. Sage Vasishta came and he gave him the Yoga Vasishta. This is before our Vishwamitra took Ram and Lakshman for the protection of the Yajna, before Tadkavad. But Ramchandraji lists question and answers with the Vashishji Maharaj. And what was the result? A realized Ram, who ruled for 11,000 years, but realized. So as long as we are keeping this self as an object to be gained, an object to be experienced, something to be worked out, something to be sorted within ourselves. No, you don't have to sort anything. You are that. So are we applying that this reality I am, or are we looking at reality only as a concept of the intellect? Because if it is a concept of the intellect, it will be a thought. Are you considering yourself to be the one who is other than the thought, who is illuminating the thought, who is expressing as the thought, who is the material of the thought. Are you considering all these things? Or are we lost only in the thoughts? That yes, now this is very clear, now that is clear, then the next Upanishad will say, which will say absolutely opposite to what was told here, and then you will say, "Arey yaar, what is this?" And this confusion will continue, because as long as we maintain the objectivity of experience, there is no conclusion. In this objective world, there are no permanent answers. Meaning, in the thought world, meaning in the mind, meaning as long as you are functioning with your triputi, subject, object, and the object of instrument of knowledge, knower, known, knowing, experiencer, experience, expressing, seer, seen, seeing, hearer, heard, hearing. As long as you are stuck in these three, truth is far, 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 far away. Even though it is the closest to you, yet it seems so far away. And this distance between that which is closest to you and yet seems far away is the emptiness that Narad Muni felt, is the emptiness that a seeker feels because of his pursuit of the truth objectively. And you know, after some time, he may lose the plot and go into sadness, depression. It's only because he is so eager to know, but he is not able to make that shift from objective to subjective. So the teacher had given to the student the Shruti Praman, the quotes of the various Upanishads, and said in his own words that Shruti Mata is also saying the same thing what I am telling you, meaning what was the doctrine? Avijnatam vijanatam, that those who know it, it is unknown to them. And why is it said again? Then yadi brahma atyantam eva avijnatam, and so on. And there it was said, because the knower of truth remains unknown. Therefore, it is the knower of truth remains unknown, because there is no knower of truth. Therefore, it is told avijnatam vijanatam, and who does not know, meaning he who does not know the truth, he knows it in the sense who does not come to a conclusion. But, and it is a direct experience. How can that person say, "I know it"? Because is he and the truth separate? How can he see it separate to say that "I know it"? And therefore, iti avrutam, mean that he knows it. Then the student here, katham tu tad brahma samyak samyak viditam bhavati evam arthamaha. So the student again, how is this reality known then? Can it be ever known by anyone? You're just taking me for a ride for last so many verses, chapter 1, chapter 2. But here, the teacher understand, the student has contemplated on what the teacher has said and come back and told to the teacher, remember what he told? what was it on which? Naham manyesu vedeti no na vedeti vedacha no nastadva veda tadveda no na vedeti vedacha. And now, after the second verse, the Shruti Mata, remember, that was the experience of the seeker. And we had put a pause, pressed the pause button after the second verse. And in the third verse, the Shruti Mata, the Upanishad, again takes up what could his experience mean. And what does it mean? Avignatam vijanatam. This is what it means. That the truth cannot, the truth, even though it is your direct experience, it is unknown to the one who is abiding in the truth. See? Just like you have the eyes, but the eyes are unavailable as an object of experience for your own eyes. You understand what we are saying? You know you have a mind, but mind remains an unknown to the mind itself, because the moment mind starts contemplating on the mind, how does it do it? We are talking about it. So the thoughts are coming, the words are there, the mind is contemplating on the mind. These are words coming and going, changing. But what is mind? Is thought equal to mind? No. Mind is the substratum on which the thoughts are coming and going. Mind doesn't come and go. Mind remains the same because it is essentially consciousness. So even from the thought point of view, so is when we just take it as mind and thoughts, can you come to know the mind? If you go, when we are saying observe your mind, people normally, naturally observe the thoughts. They don't observe the mind. If you observe the mind, you will vanish, you will be established in the self. Story over. But we only observe the thoughts. So same way, just like mind cannot come to know. So mind is there, but mind is an unknowable to the mind itself. Eyes are there, but eyes are unknowable to the vision itself. Similarly, the truth is there. It is the substratum. It is the constant. The one who is established in that, to him, it is an unknowable. It cannot become an experience. So therefore, if Brahman cannot be known, then the fool and the wise both are same. Then the fool and wise both are same. So how can the truth be known, sir? The Shruti Mata is putting this question. She is contemplating within herself for our benefit. She's just taking that second verse and delving deeper. Now the third verse that comes, a long commentary is there. So we'll see. What does it mean to know the truth or be the truth or abide in the truth? What is the application? Where can it be caught? When the student is saying, how can the truth be known? If it is an unknowable, is it possible then? Yes, it is possible. Now Shruti Mata is giving you a way out. Way. Pratibodha viditam matam. Pratibodha viditam matam. Amrutatvam hi vindate. अमृतत्वं हि विन्दते आत्मना विन्दते वीर्यम् आत्मना विन्दते वीर्यम् विद्यया विन्दते अमृतम् विद्यया विन्दते अमृतम् प्रतिबोधविदितं मतम् अमृतत्वं हि विन्दते आत्मना विन्दते वीर्यम् विद्यया विन्दते अमृतम् What does it say here? It says that which is pratyaksha. Pratyaksha means what? Pratyaksha is that which is in front, that which is seen by you. What is seen by you? How it is seen by you? You can say, I can see you all. But can I really see you all? Where am I seeing you all? I am seeing you all in the screen of the laptop. I'm not seeing you. I'm seeing your smile. I'm seeing your eyes. I'm seeing your movement. I'm seeing your, whatever the emotions are coming across. But where am I seeing? I'm seeing it with my eyes. I'm talking to you. But where can I see? I can see them on the screen of the laptop. Similarly, whatever I know, bodha, the word is pratibodha viditam matam. So what is bodha? Bodha is everything that is which is known. Everything that which is known. How do you know it? How do you know everything? By way of thought. Isn't it? Without thought, I cannot know you. I cannot say this is Bodh, this is computer, this is Meena, this is the screen of the laptop, this is the book, this is the chair. Every moment, every word that is uttered from the mouth is expressing some knowledge. Why only all these different objects which are appearing as a thought? The thought, the is not, there is no object called the out there. There is no object called is. There is no object called on. But the thought itself is an object, isn't it? Because what is an object? What is the nature?
Self. Huh? Anything that's out there and not self.
Yes.
Becomes a thought.
Yes. Very good. Anything that is which is other than the self, meaning anything that which is coming and going, impermanent, finite, changing, that is not self, isn't it? And that is a thought. You cannot come to know this world without a thought. If your mind is blank, you cannot come to know the world. So whatever you know, you only know because you have a, what is that? You have a thought about it in your mind. So here it says, Pratibodha viditam matam amritatvam hi vindate. So he who knows the constant principle behind every object of knowledge, meaning here only it is an assessment, it's an inference. But that inference has to be made into a direct experience. And what is that? That constant principle behind every thought. Now, don't start looking, oh my God, there is a constant principle behind every thought. Let me look for it, where it is, where it is. No, you are that. Otherwise, you will start another search behind in the mind and become confused and delusory. So, amrutatvam hi vindate. Understand that constant principle, that unchanging principle, in spite of waking, dream, deep sleep coming and going. That constant principle, in spite of all the thoughts that are being heard by you or all the words that are being spoken right now by me, this is for myself. The words are coming and going. The feelings are coming and going. The thoughts are coming and going. But am I coming and going? No. Who is this who is not coming and going? That is the Pratyagatma. That is the unchanging principle. Be aware. Just as you can never see your own physical eyes, but don't you know that there is eyes? You know it. Without looking into the mirror, you know the eyes are there. That will be the pratyak bodh of the eyes. So same way, what is that? In whose light the thoughts are illuminating? What is that in whose light the thoughts are getting illuminated? See, sun does not know he is of the nature of heat and light because these two are inseparable from him. It is his nature. Sun also doesn't know that he is giving light to the earth in whose light we are able to see all the objects of the earth. You understand what I'm saying? The sun doesn't know that he is the source of all light on the planet earth. And the sun also doesn't know that he is the source of the absence of light on this earth. But without him, the light and the absence of light both cannot happen without the sun. Agree or not? So what is that principle? Catch that principle, be that principle, or it is that constant who is illuminating the presence of the thought and its absence. Just as, but from the self point of view, there is no illumination or non-illumination. Just as from sun's point of view, there is no day and there is no night. Similarly, from the self point of view, there is no, self is sitting there with a torchlight. Acha bhai, aaja, which is the next thought? Acha, ye thought hai. Chalo, ab kya hoga? Ab there is no thought. This particular exercise can be easily practiced and come to a conclusion if you practice Vaikhari Madhyama Pashyanti Para. Very clearly, you can catch this. See, why we are not able to catch? Because the thought flow is so fast in our mind. There is a raging river of thoughts, fueled by desire. Ye padhu, wo padhu. For one moment also we can't sit silent. कभी न्यूज चल रहा है, कभी सीरियल चल रहा है, कभी सत्संग चल रहा है, कभी वी वॉन्ट टू वॉट इज कॉल्ड नॉइज पोल्यूशन इज गोइंग ऑन. बिकॉज द मोमेंट साइलेंस इज देयर वी आर फोर्स्ड, वी फॉल बैक इन टू आवर सेल्स. Majority people are afraid of facing themselves. So, keeping that aside, the one who has come to know the constant principle behind all the bodha, all the objective thought knowledge, that constant alone is the Brahman. By being that constant, here it says, amrutatvam hi vindate, one gains immortality. What does it mean, one gains immortality? One is no longer then shunted into birth and death cycle. That is immortality. Freedom from birth and death is immortality. Going to heaven is not immortality. Once you have enjoyed, because you have listened to satsang, your punya is going into your bank account. Because why? I heard Keno Upanishad, I heard Ishavasya Upanishad, I heard Bhagavatam. So in, also in my case, I gave lecture. This fellow gave lectures. Lot of punya getting accrued. Kahan bhejna bhai? Chalo, heaven. Kuske baad, thoda enjoy kar liya. Kya? Bhook nahi lagti, sari ichhaen puri ho jati hain. And then what to do? Okay, punya over. What to do now? Pop back on the earth. Again birth. Again studies. Again shushushishi. Again struggling to survive. So immortality is where there is no birth and death thereafter. Atmana vindate viryam, the amrutatva, the immortality is gained by your own self, not by knowing anything else other. Then what is yourself? I? What Brahman Maharishi practiced? Who am I? He asked once and he stayed with it. So don't look at it as a, for that you have to take one step further within yourself, and that is, this body is not I, this breath is not I, these emotions are not I, these concepts are not I, this knower is not I, this known is not I, the knowing is not I. Then who is this I? The I is independent of the Triputi, the triad. For that you have to slow down. And that's why it is told again and again in other yesterday Sunday morning's text. When you go to sleep and when you wake up in the morning, your mind is naturally quiet. Kya ho gaya yaar?
Alert from software update.
Keep quiet, man. So, where was I? Ye software. Hum apne aap ko update kar rahe hai, ye software bhi apne aap ko update kar rahe hai. So, before going to sleep and after waking up, that opportunity was that moment where everything has naturally left your mind, and in the morning when naturally your mind is calm without any clutter of the waking world. That time you are naturally, your mind is quiet. Catch yourself, be yourself. Vidyaya vindate amrutam. So with the vidyaya, with the knowledge. Knowledge means thought knowledge. So with the thought knowledge, only the darkness of ignorance can be known, because ignorance alone expresses as avidya kama karma. Ignorance alone expresses as all the names and forms. Ignorance alone is the entire objectivity. So when you are at the thought knowledge level, it is only the knowledge of the ignorance, meaning not self. Not self is equal to ignorance. And in this way, this verse, Pratibodha Viditam Matam Amritatvam Hi Vindate Atmana Vindate Viryam Vidyaya Vindate Mrutam. So with thoughts, what can we do? With the thoughts, can we come to know the self? No. Then what can we do with the thoughts? Only one thing. We can remove the ignorant thoughts. So if everything is ignorance, that ignorance is divided into two: thoughts of knowledge and thoughts of ignorance. So what is thoughts of knowledge doing? Thoughts of knowledge are removing thoughts of ignorance. How long will they keep doing? Till there is a thought of ignorance. How long will the camphor burn? As long as there is some material called camphor to be burned, which is expressing as flame. So how long have you to keep this exercise of thought knowledge? As long as there is thought of ignorance there. How long do you keep thinking of the thought of sleep? As long as there is still some thought of the waking disturbing your mind. When the last thought of the waking by itself leaves your mind, is unable to make impact on your mind, even the thought of sleep also goes away. Exactly the same way. Here it is told, Vidyaya Vindate Amritam. The only thing that the vidya, the knowledge, can bring about is remove the thoughts of ignorance, the thoughts of the not self. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 pages of Bhashya is there now. So we'll go through it as best as we can. Not as best, whatever is there, we'll see. But you have to maintain patience, because it is going deep. It is, imagine the concentration that a doctor needs when he is doing a open heart surgery. Imagine the concentration that is needed when you are doing the brain surgery. A wrong pin in the brain somewhere and some functionality of your body will stop. Imagine. That much alertness and attention is required when we are going through this. I have given it to you in a gist. Now he's going to just go into a bit more detail. Pratibodha viditam bodham bodham pratividitam बोध शब्देन बौद्धाः प्रत्यया उच्यन्ते सर्वे प्रत्यया विषयी भवन्ति यस्य स आत्मा सर्वबोधन बोधान प्रति बुध्यते He says that which can be revealed, that which can be revealed, which can be available, which can be recognized in every experience is knowledge. So what is this Baudha Pratyaya? Baudha word is taken here. Baudha is that which is recognized, through a thought. That which cannot be recognized through a thought is not a Baudha Pratyaya. And as I told you before, the entire experience of ours is only through thought. Even that nothing, absence of all objects, we call it as space. And that space also we have given a name, space, Akash. And we say we know space, even though we have never had an experience of absence. This is the height of our ignorance. So, pratibodha viditam, bodham pratividitam. Bodham means every thought is a place where truth is revealed. Now, you don't have to go far away. You don't have to go to Tirtha Yatra. You don't have to go and do big, great anushthan of, I'm going to chant 1 crore of Hare Ram, Hare Ram mantra, or I'm going to chant 2 crores of Om, or I'm going to chant Om Vishnave Nama, or Om Namah Shivaya. You can do it. You can take anushthan, no problem. Life must be lived with discipline. At least it's keeping you away from the world. What will happen if you practice Vaikhari Madhyama Pashyanti Para? As you come to be in a refined state, as you move from Vaikhari Madhyama, this recognition comes about. And you don't have to do Vaikhari Madhyama. If you are very, very alert and cool and available at this moment, it can be, what is being said is yours right here and now. And what is said, bodham, means every thought is a place where truth is revealed. Every thought is a place where truth is revealed. Is truth other than the thought? If we saw Ishavasya Upanishad, wait, what did it say? That it is the nimitta karan and what do you call? Upadan karan. It is the material. Is water other than wave? Or without wave, without water, the wave cannot exist? See? So can thought exist without consciousness, without the reality, without the Atma, without the spirit? How do we catch it? First point is made, bodham, pratibodha viditam, meaning bodham. Wherever a thought is taking place, there alone truth is revealed with every thought. He who is illuminating every thought is the Atma. So therefore, then what is to be done? Be indifferent to every thought. be indifferent to every thought. Then that is, if we are indifferent to every thought, meaning we are not giving value to the thought, we are not giving importance to the thought, we are not desiring any thought, we are not holding on to any thought, then what are we having? We are having udasin bhav towards thought, meaning we are indifferent towards the thought. Hai to hai, ye bhi nahi ki hai to hai, theek hai, padhe raho. Right now you are having udasin bhav towards whatever is in your room because you are focused here. When you go to sleep, you are focused on the sleep, but you are having udasin bhav towards all the experiences of the waking. That is udasin bhav. That is why they are getting flushed out of your mind at such a great pace by themselves. You are not plucking them out of your mind. They are getting flushed out by themselves. Why? Udasin bhav. So same way, have udasin bhav towards the thoughts, and that is what you call baudha pratyaya. Here it is told, bodha shabdena baudhaha pratyaya uchyante. This is on page 73. Sarve pratyaya vishayi bhavanti yasya sa atma sarva bodhan prati buddhyate. So in every knowledge, I is the common denominator. When we get carried away or influenced by the thoughts, then as if reality is forgotten, as if the reality is disrespected. Where? Right here. So when we get carried away by the thoughts, now I tell you, think of your husband, think of corona, think of your children, think of your childhood. Immediately the one thought leads to another thought. If I think of both, immediately Prakash will also come. It will lead to Prakash, then it will lead to her daughter, then it will lead to her son-in-law, then it will lead to the satsang that I had at her place. Then it leads to the salad that her husband makes. See how deep it goes. Similarly with everyone. Why? No, just with me, every one of you. If you think of, if I think of this book, Durga Saptashati, immediately the thought comes. All the pages are coming together. I think this was the first Durga Saptashati that I bought, and I know where I bought it. Immediately one thing leads to the next. And what happens? We get enslaved by the thoughts. So the moment thought becomes more important, and thought is always about some object, as it becomes more important, the self becomes unimportant. And that is what is being told here. So, the first point is, when object is given importance, then that object exists or is absent. This is the first point. When object is given importance, it exists or it is absent. So object is absent also because you have given importance to the object. You are not given importance to the absence. Then second point, when importance is given to experience, and that experience can be good or bad. So first is importance is given to the object, presence or absence. Second, importance is given to the experience. And third, the importance is given to the individuality. And this individuality is the one who becomes happy or miserable, sukhi or dukhi. So when importance is given to the experience, then there will be sukh or dukh. But when importance is given to the individuality, then precipitation of sukhi dukhi personality comes about. So so in this way, Paramatma is just behind the curtain of these thoughts. And when importance is not given to the object, to the experience, to the experiencer, the individuality, meaning the triputi, the triad, the knower, known, knowing, the experiencer, experience, experiencing, in short, subject, object, and the instrument of knowledge. When these three are, and it is what you're doing. You're not giving importance to waker, waking experience, and waking world. You're not giving importance to dreamer, dream experience, and dream world. That's why you keep moving on to the next state. When you are going to sleep, you are not giving importance to the waker, waking world and waking experience. When you wake up from the dream, you are not giving importance to the dreamer, dream world and the dream experience. Triputi, triputi, triad. That is at a large scale. You can keep that, hold it in your mind and stay there. Or if your thoughts are, you are able to slow down your thoughts, then catch this, what we are saying, that these three are not given importance. And when we do not give importance to these three, the object, the experience, or the experiencer, then we are said to be, then one is said, not we, then one is said to be equanimous, samyakdarshi. Samyakdarshi, sarva pratyaya darshi chit shakti swarupa matra pratyaya pratyayahi eva pratyayeshu avishishtataya lakshate. Such a person is called samyakdarshi. He is equanimous. And so what is this sarva pratyaya? See, you can, in Bhagavat we came across the different type of pralaya. Pralaya, another word means destruction, dissolution, death, different names. There is nitya pralaya. There is atyantika pralaya, there is prakritik pralaya or laya, and there is one more, the first one, naimittika pralaya. Naimittika, prakritika, prakritik, nitya and atyantika. So either you take the dissolution, which is equal to death, which is equal to non-manifestation, which is equal to absorption, which is equal to absence, which is equal to nothingness, emptiness. Now you take it at a totality level or keep coming micro, 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 micro. Every year, every 365 days, the year unmanifests, 2020 unmanifested, 2021 manifested. In this 2021, already the summer has unmanifested, the autumn has begun. Now autumn is unmanifesting and winter is manifesting. We are only halfway through it. Come closer. Every day, now the day has unmanifested and the night is manifesting, absence is manifesting, ignorance is manifesting. And what will happen eventually? Everything will become unknown to you. Deep darkness in sleep, total ignorance. So everything is becoming unmanifest. Tomorrow again, manifestation of the... So we are coming closer. Now come now. What is happening? Every time I blink my eyes, vision is unmanifest. I can't illuminate anything. I open, everyone becomes available. Same thing is with all the five senses. Even if the five senses are open, if the mind is, have I trained my mind to go with the thoughts or not to go with the thoughts? Can I catch the presence of the thoughts and the absence of the thoughts? Are we able to catch the manifestation? Because every thought that appears in your mind cannot come without the subject, object, and the instrument. So is your attention on the object of the thought? Is your attention on the experience of the thought? Is your attention on the knower of the thought? I am thinking. When we have become free from all these three, this is coming very subjective now. So we have brought you from 365 days in a year. You can go atyantik is even further. It goes up to the gods. They also unmanifest. I only took you from the year and then back to where we are right now. So everything is in our presence. Because thoughts are coming and going, have we come and gone? Are we giving importance to the experiencer, experienced, or experiencing? Let it be, let it go on. It is going on at the equipment level, let it go on. You remain undisturbed, poised. Then you are Samyak Darshi. Then you are the Pratyagatma. Then you are the equanimous being. That itself is reality. That itself is Brahman. So to recognize, sarva pratyaya means to recognize that these three, what we just talked about, the object, the object of knowledge, the knowledge of object, and the third is the knower of the object, the subject, object, and the experience. In between. Object of knowledge, knowledge of object, and knower of object. These are the three. Sarva pratyaya, sarva, all the pratyas, all the aspects. What are the aspects? These three are the aspects of a triad, of a thought, of any knowledge. through thoughts. Then all these three are, we are udasin, we are indifferent towards them, then the Paramatma or the Atma, then it reveals itself. But if we give value, see, how do we give value to the knower of the object? How do you give value to the knower? By having the Abhiman. I know it. I am speaking. Speaking is happening. Unnecessarily, you put your nose into it and say, I am speaking. I made my own life. I went through the hardships. You know that. I brought up my kids single-handedly. My husband was useless. Arrogance, Abhiman. It's a good survival skill. But that survival is on, keeps you in the relativity. It is necessarily in the relative world, no doubt. But as a seeker, we need to bring ourselves to bring that up also, give that up also. And it will not go away so easily. And therefore, we are studying how we can soften the impact when it goes away. Otherwise, before it goes away, because it's in the mind only, mind doesn't want to die. It brings up n number of ways to maintain its existence. N number of ways. Creates confusion, creates doubts. It feels as if you're losing your mind. You have to lose the mind if you want to know the truth. You have to lose your mind if you want to go to sleep every night. Don't you? That time you don't complain that I'm losing my mind, I'm losing my thoughts, now I can't even think what I have to do tomorrow, why sleep is coming. Why don't you say, I can't think of anything, now realization is coming closer. I'm just at the threshold of equanimity. Why don't you sing this song? For sleep, no problem. When it comes to relation, all complications we bring in.
Sarva pratyaya darshi chit shakti swarupa matra pratyaya hi eva pratyayeshu avishishtataya lakshate.
He says, the one who is the seer of everything, sarva pratyaya darshi, the one who is seer of everything,
chit shakti swarupa matra,
and what is this seer of everything? He, that is experience, that he is absolutely so aware, so alert, so vigilant that the experience, and in each experience there is a trio, there is this triad, and is that he, I am the, this is without saying, that I am the illuminator of these trio. And in this way, I am the illuminator of this chit shakti swarupa matra pratyaya eva. Pratyaya hi eva. That each, the object, object of knowledge, knowledge of object, and the knower of the object. These three distinct parts are there. Have we able to catch this in our mind? Such person is the darshi, sarva pratyaya darshi.
Pratyaya means the parts. These are the three parts by which knowledge takes place in our mind. Without these three, no knowledge can take place. Here, knowledge means thought knowledge. I'm not talking about who is Bodh, who is Meena, who is computer, what is computer, no. Bodh. Bodh is a word. Computer is a word. How is this knowledge taking place? Without, can it be possible without the knower of the object? No. If there is no object, is knowledge possible? No. If there is no instrument, only subject and object are there, is knowledge possible? No. If object and instrument is there, and there is no knower, is thought possible? No. So these three basic ingredients are required in order for a thought knowledge to be formed. Bodham, Bodham. Remember how we began to this verse? This is Sarva Pratyaya, these three Pratyayas. So in this way, Chit Shakti Swarupa Matraha Pratyayaihi Eva the in case of pure knowledge, the pure consciousness without the medium of thought, Chit Shakti, conscious power, conscious knowledge, Swarupa Matraha. What is this conscious knowledge? Chit Shakti hi Swarupa Matra, that which is without these three Pratyayas, or that which is supporting these three but not affected by these three, that foundation. So that consciousness without the three Pratyayas or the medium of thought, what is that? What does it say? Eva Pratyayeshu Avishishtataya. Avishishtataya means without the specificity of thought. Vishishta, Vishesha. Without the specificity, without the knower known knowledge, without the subject, object, and instrument. Without the object of knowledge, without the first, second, without the knowledge of object two, and without the knower of object three. The three Pratyayas. These are three specific, which come together to bring about another specific. This is specific knowledge. Vishesha Jnana. Just like water meets water to form a wave. Just like certain conditions, the sunlight, the moisture in the air, the heat of the earth, these three ingredients have to be in the right mix in order for a third thing to come about, which is called mirage waters. Or the, if not the earth, the rainbow also comes under the same, the angle of light and the moisture in the air has to be in perfect, matra in order for rainbow to come about. So is the moisture equal to rainbow? No. Is the light equal to rainbow? No. But two of them come together to form a third thing called the object. Same way, the is there a waker? It seems to appear every morning. let's take dream. Is there a dreamer? Dreamer seems to appear every night. He's an experiencer of what? Dream world. So that's the second aspect, second pratyaya. And what is the third? The experience of the subject and the object. Waker, dreamer, dream world is the object of knowledge. And dreaming is the knowledge of object. And dreamer is the knower of object. So these three come together to give you a third thing called an experience of dream. Similarly, these three come together to give a third thing called a thought. How do you know yourself? By thought, I am this body. I got a beard. I am listening to satsang. I am giving satsang. I am seeing, I am hearing, I am talking, I am thinking. And I know it is time to close. All this how? See? So catch here, as I said, you have to be alert and attentive. It's going to take you deep into, if you are in tune with what is going on, you will catch it. There's no question about it. So, pratyayeshu avishishtataya lakshate. So, therefore, this consciousness, this knowledge is undifferentiated, undisturbed by these three. It is avishishtata. So, vishishta is these three specific. Avishishta, it is non-specific. What is non-specific? Non-specific, chit chakti swarupa bhava matraha. So that chit chakti, that conscious principle is avishishta. It is non-specific, meaning it does not have any contours, meaning it does not have a form, meaning it cannot be experienced as an object, meaning it cannot be objectified, meaning it cannot come and go like thoughts come and go. Avishishtata. Why we are giving these all adjectives? So that you recognize this is what you are. You are avishishta. You are the chit shakti swarupa matra. And that chit shakti, that conscious principle, that conscious power is avishishta, which is non-specific. And in its light, the thoughts get illuminated. How do they get illuminated? Am I standing there and giving light? No. Sun is not giving light to the earth. Sun is where he is. The phenomena of the light is taking place. Similarly, the Atma Tattva, the conscious principle, is as it is. We'll just do one, that last part. Na anyad dwaram antaratmano vijnanaya. So here is a, this is the final word about this pratyagatma, about Brahman, about the reality. This is the final word. And this is the way you can come to know it. And in this particular way, this is the only way. There's no other way. They keep saying that in every Upanishad. Kuch to click ho. So there's no other way other than this reality. So find the truth behind the thoughts. You are not creative. Thoughts are coming and going. Let your attention, rather than being on the thought, let it be attention. We are not saying think about the constant principle. Don't think about the constant principle. Be it. If you force your mind to think about the constant principle, then the mind will react again. Let the mind think what it's thinking. Are you forcing the mind to think of sleep? No, you're thinking of sleep. Mind is thinking about the world. Sometimes it thinks about what it has to do. Sometimes it thinks about scratching. Sometimes it thinks about changing the position. Sometimes it thinks, where is the wind coming from in the bed? But while thinking all this, it doesn't forget that its main purpose is to sleep. That it wants to dive into the embrace of the sleep. So while we are functioning, while we are thinking, while we are moving around in the waking, do we know our final destination? That we want to be in the embrace of ourselves, of the self, of the pure consciousness that we are? Or are we embracing the thoughts and considering them to be the source of joy, peace, tranquility, completion? Then we'll keep birth after birth if we keep doing that. Therefore, freedom from thoughts does not mean removing thoughts. Freedom from thoughts means reverting back to the consciousness. That's what it means. So who am I? I am that in whose illumination the presence as well as the absence get illumined. And I am unaffected by either of them. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om.
Hari Om. Hari Om, Swamiji.
Hari Om, Hari Om, Prabhu.
Hari Om, Swamiji.
Hari Om, Swamiji.
Hari Om.
Hari Om, Swamiji.
Hari Om, Hari Om. I'll sign out.
Yep. Hari Om, Swamiji.
Hari Om. Take care.